Chapter 5, The Sound of Silence. The rest is silent. Silence. Shakespeare. Take a rest. Ovid said that silence is strength. If that's true, you'll be much stronger after this chapter because it's all about silence. Silence in music is as important as sound. And of course, we crafty humans have invented a way to show this silence in music. Rests. Rest lengths and rest names are the same as the note lengths you learned in the last chapter. The three you'll be learning in this chapter are whole rests, half rests, and quarter rests. The rests of the story. Whole rests are 4 beats long. They're a rectangle that hang down from the 4th line of the music staff. Half rests are 2 beats long. They're also a rectangle, and they are coming up from the 3rd line of the music staff. Quarter rests are 1 beat long and look nothing like either of the first two. A quarter rest is a squiggly line that goes over the middle 3 lines of the music staff, or directly in the middle of a 1-line music staff. With the quarter rest, it's a very good idea to take a look at the images that go along with this book on the web. Whole or half, whole or hat. Whole rests and half rests look very much the same and can be easily confused with each other, especially at first. Here's a way to remember which is which. The whole rest looks like a hole in the ground, like so. And you see an image of the whole rest with a skateboarder jumping over the hole. You can remember which is the half rest by seeing that the half rest looks sort of like a hat. I know half and hat aren't perfect homophones like whole and whole, but work with me. Drawing a quarter rest. This is probably one of the trickiest symbols to make in written music, but it certainly isn't tough. Make a letter Z, then put a letter C right below it. It won't look exactly like the real quarter rests you'll see in this chapter, but anyone who reads music will know what it is, as long as you aren't too sloppy with it. This will be easier to do by hand than with the Parisian font I've used in the example to the right. There are many fonts on most computers that allow you to create musical notation, like Maestro, Opus, and the musical font I've chosen for this book, Helsinki. Rests on the staff. Whole rests hang from the 4th line of the staff. Half rests sit on the 3rd line, and quarter rests are plastered over the middle 3 lines. Notice that the brim of the hat and the edges of the whole are gone when the half and whole rests are written on the proper line. It just looks like a black rectangle. Rests on the single line staff. When using the single line staff, whole rests will hang down from the staff. Half rests will sit on the staff line, and quarter rests are centered on the staff line. Long rests. Rests can be stretched out over several measures, and instead of writing a whole bunch of whole rests, the measures of rests are combined, and the music is marked with how many measures of rest are to be counted. In the following example, you'd rest for 14 measures. Moving on. Without silence, there can be no sound. Without sound, there can be no silence. Now you know how to show silence in music using whole, half, and quarter rests. Make sure you can answer all the study guide questions for this chapter before you move on. Coming up next is the review for all of Part 1. This is very important information, so be sure you've got it all before you move on. It's pretty common to review this information several times until it sticks. Keep at it.